backup router. So to backup the router, first of all we need to provide the IP address. IP address is on. So IP is already provided. We just given the gateway also, 10.1. Router interface address and verify the, yeah. So IP address is already provided. So I want to take a backup of your router IOS. So first of all, need to find the flash, show flash, to verify the name of your IOS. Right, select on it and copy it, because we need to manually type. So copy flash, and backup should always take on the TFTP server. So we need a device which have a TFTP server. So we need to take a server machine which have a TFTP server. But in real scenario, we can install the TFTP server on desktop also. It's a very tiny software, you can download from the Google.
Okay.
So you can see a TFTP server is already inside that machine. And now we just provide the IP address, 10.0.0.2 and 10.1 as a gateway. So now copy flash on TFTP. Copy flash TFTP, then it will ask about the source file name, means your IOS file name. I have pasted the name. Then asking for remote host. Remote host means the IP address of your server machine. That is 2. Okay. I forget. I think 2 or 2. So then need to give the IP address 10.2 and the destination. In the destination, what file name you need to save. So give any name, like I just give my iOS. So it has saved your all iOS information, iOS file to the TFTP server. So we can verify on TFTP server. Just go to services, then TFTP. Now you can check your iOS file is copy. Okay. So in this way, we can copy the Cisco iOS on our router. In the same manner, we can restore or we can say the update. Like if you want to update the new iOS, we just need to copy the iOS on the TFTP server, and from TFTP server we can upload to the router. So how to update? Like assume the condition my iOS file, which is on the server machine, it's updated iOS version. So we need to just copy that updated iOS version to the router. So
okay.
Copy TFTP server to the flash. Earlier we have done copy flash to TFTP. Now the command is reverse. Copy TFTP to flash. Then given the IP address of our TFTP server.
Okay.
Yeah. 10.2, the source file name, what is the file inside that, my iOS.
Okay.
Destination, what name you want to remain, the same name I want to remain. Now you can see it's accessing from TFTP or it's copied. So now checks show flash. So it's showing my iOS in the same manner, Cisco 226. So now we need to set the boot variables. Go to the config T. Boot system flash, and we need to give the command name of my iOS, my iOS. Now save it, and if you want to verify, just delete the older one. Like I just delete older one, delete flash, and what is the name of my flashes earlier, this. So I just remove the earlier iOS name. I now need to verify show flash. So you will find only single iOS name, my iOS. So to confirm this, we just need to reload the router. First of all, WR, then reload. So your router is booted again. It means they are taking the new iOS. So from new iOS, like my iOS, they are running because we have already removed the older iOS. Okay. So in this way, either we can upgrade the router iOS, and either we can use the fresh installation. So we can upgrade, or I can use the fresh upgrade. So this is how we do the command line in the routers. Like, we have configured the different interfaces, learn about the router CLI modes, how to protect your router, how to break your router password, and how to backup and restore your. Okay. In the same manner, we can take a backup of your configuration file, because configuration file is also more important rather than the iOS, because iOS we can take from the internet, but configuration file we can't take from the internet, because once my configuration file is lost,